Hey, Water's Edge, Matt Hoover here, your friendly neighborhood campus pastor. And I'm not sure about you, but yesterday's finale of our relationship series, Kiss, was absolutely incredible. Now, in case you missed it, spoiler alert, it was all about how we use our words and the world our words create. Now, there was a moment during Pastor Sue's message that really stuck out to me, one that I would love to give you my thoughts about, but before I do that, I'd love to share with you the moment that stuck out to me. So, check this out.
Speak to others as you would have them speak to you. That's a relationship principle. Y'all, that will, I believe, radically transform your relationships. In fact, I don't know if there's anything in our relationships today, and I'm talking about relationships with your spouse or with your parents or with your kids or with your friends. I'm talking about relationships with your boss or your coworkers and even relationships with crappy customer service people, all right? I'm talking about all the relationships, all of them in your life. I don't think there's anything that complicates our relationships more than our words. In fact, that's why I believe KISS principle number 4 is vitally important for our lives. And y'all, I'm just going to give it to you today straight from Scripture. I don't even need to like simplify it or reword it or repackage it so you remember. It's so straightforward. It's so direct. It's so in your face. It's so not complicated, not complex. It is so simple. You ready for it? This is KISS principle number 4. The tongue has the power of life and death. Boom, right? In our face, right? The way we communicate, the words we choose, the way we deliver those words from our lips, they can either bring life in a relationship or death to a relationship. So when I speak, when I communicate, when I open my mouth and choose my words, I'm going to speak life.
Come on, everybody, speak life. So simple and so incredibly powerful. Now, as I was listening to Pastor Stu's message, I thought of two things I'd love to share with you here today. The first is this: I can speak life. Now, I know this may seem like a duh statement, but how often do we remind ourselves that we have the power to speak life to others? Oh my gosh, I know I don't remind myself nearly enough. Now, I don't know about you, but I need to remind myself multiple times a day that I have the power to speak life to others. Now, let's do something fun and powerful together. Repeat this after me. Say, I can speak life. Come on, everybody. That simple declaration can change the way you communicate and change the way your communication affects others. I can speak life, and you can speak life too. Now, the second thing I thought about as Pastor Stu was sharing was death is the default. Because we're all sinners saved by grace, we tend to naturally bend towards negativity and hopelessness and carelessness and selfishness. And many times when we follow that ever so natural path, our words tend to follow too. So guys, knowing our words will be death by default and that we have the power to speak life, let's choose today to guard ourselves against the temptation to use our words to bring death, and let's choose to speak life today.